What's up guys, welcome back for another Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro Duel video of Handle Magician's new format again TCG May 2018. You know, throughout the comments sometimes people are posting Handle Magicians are dead, and to some extent, for the most obvious reasons, Astrograph Sorcerer pretty much carried the entire deck. Okay, you had a couple of sub-engines, like here in the deck for example, but you know, the play of Electromite into Astrograph Sorcerer was just far too strong. But again, Astrograph Sorcerer is now banned for the upcoming TCG ban list, so the deck has to adapt, and as I mentioned before, the deck still has a couple of sub-engines to carry the deck, make your Electromite summon much more easy, and you know, opening up multiple extra monster zones, and you know, make your Pendulum summon the most efficient thing. Well, anyway, the Mythical Beasts, I think, are one of those biggest sub-engines you need to play. The level 6 Pendulum Magician is super clutch. You need it. Again, it just opens up a possible rank 6 exceed play. It easily gives you the extra, you know, Pendulum monster on your side of the field. Your Chronograph Sorcerer, by the way. Of course, you have your Dark Worm engine. Definitely super solid. To again, just, you know, make your Electromite much more easy. The deck definitely needs work. Maybe more hand traps. I think you still need those going into the new TCG format, especially with Brandish as well coming out soon, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. Again, feel free to correct me, right? Pot of Desire is a bit iffy. I've seen builds with Allure of Darkness in the main deck. But yeah, again, Desires is in the main deck. 40 cards, by the way. Going first, again, I believe, you know, you should be going first, right? And not make, at least not give your opponent the opportunity to establish his board. You want to establish your own board, and that's still the same as you want here with Pendulum Magicians. And the new trick, well, it's not really new, I think, but due to the fact that you're, at least Pendulum Magicians lost the Astrograph Sorcerer, it just made you, you know, your pluses much easier to get. And at the same time, getting like an instant level 7 on your side of the field, making your rank 7 play into eventually your Odd Eyes Vortex. Again, just a piece of cake, right? But now, something like the FA, the new level, well, new, yeah, I think it's new, for the TCG at least, the new level 7 FA Synchro Monster that can negate like a spell from the opponent, for example, by just, you know, reducing its level and eventually its attack as well, but let alone, and your plays are pretty much the same, right? You can still go for the Metaltron, opening up the 3 extra monster zones, and by that time, you're also sending that rank 7 exceed, the Absolute Dragon, I believe, from your field to the graveyard to special summon Vortex. Vortex will give you that one negate during your opponent's turn, and potentially, if you have the FA as well, which is actually quite easy to get on the field, if you have the Chronograph Sorcerer, which is somewhat of a replacement for the loss of Astrograph Sorcerer. So again, having the level 3 and the level 4 tuner on your side of the field, going for the FA, potentially giving you the extra negation, is so good. Unbelievable good. Tornado Dragon forces out the back row, right? And now this should be game or not? Not really sure. Probably not. Yup, indeed, but again, I have two negates ready, having the Ghost Ogre in hand. He can still attack over the FA, but that's all good. Metaltron will eventually trigger, right? So, okay, the pseudo is not really that big of a deal. Needle Fiber maybe, but, you know, a Vortex can still negate that. Another example here, yep, the opponent gets to start. So going second is all fine, I guess. Currently, I'm running only 6 hand traps, but again, still pretty much early format, right? But I think it's a fact that you have to main multiple hand traps, and probably even more than they are now here in the main deck. Currently sitting at 40 cards in main deck. I want to keep it at 40, maybe 41? 41 maybe. But again, that's a little bit up to you, right? So yeah, maybe more hand traps, but that's something we have to playtest. Effect failure, not really sure. Well, maybe because of brandish, that might be a thing. But eventually, effect failure on the skull dread, that helped prevent my opponent from, you know, drawing into more traps, more hand traps, right? Drawing the monster Cerberus. Ah, man. This mythical beast engine is so, so good, giving you the more negations, right, with level 6, and potentially getting, like, a monster from your opponent's side of the field. I think it's banished with the level 8 one. Again, so, so good, and at the same time, it makes your Electromite much, at least, it just makes it much more easy to get it on the field. And anyway, a huge Pendulum Summon. Ah, yes, the, what is it called? The Xiangqi Magician? You know which one. The level 7 that you can easily special summon to your side of the field with the Harmonizing Magician, I believe the name is. And then, you know, opening up their delicious rank 7 exceed play into your Absolute Dragon and going for Metatron Vortex on your side of the field. And yep, thanks to the pseudo, I can somewhat steal the game. Well, if it wasn't for, you know, the 4k damage to his life point, the 4k cost, probably would have, I'm not really sure if I would have made other plays. Yeah, probably prevent, maybe make Borreload to prevent him from triggering the ABC monsters, but whatever, right? Having the FA, I believe, on my side of the field, and Vortex as well. Anyway, next duel against Gokis, not really TCG here with the Stromberg. Well, Stromberg is okay, I guess. I mean, if it goes off, that is. Okay, you're sacrificing a normal summon, and in this case, if your Stromberg gets, for example, yeah, gets Ghost Ogred, what are you going to do, right? You just sacrificed your normal summon for basically nothing. And he did, yeah, he did have the level 4 Goki, so he could just, you know, not use the field spell and normal summon the Goki, get the extra normal summon, I believe, and, you know, go from there. So, but, you know, just seeing both hands, it's of course much more easy to, or at least it's easier to talk about that, right? Seeing both hands. Another example, again, Goki's now. He starts off, and then, you know, sometimes people in the comments, man, you should play this against Goki's. And then I'm like, yeah, if I'm going second and I don't have a hand trap, they will just make the Troymare slash Nightmare lock loop thingy. And, you know, if I don't have the perfect hand, I can just scoop. But again, Pendulum Magicians are basically the same, right? Anyway, so again, the opponent gets to start. I believe he's going to have like a field of, I believe, Trigate Wizard? Trigate Wizard live, I believe, and not really sure, I believe also Cerberus as well, and Ibly on my side of the field, and that's a problem, and I'm not really sure how I should play around this particular field, and the play I'm going to make, as you will see in a couple of moments, is suiciding with Ibly, but I think I just should have, like, normal summoned any of my level 4s and going for the Link Summon, making the, you know, the Link 2 with, the, you know, increasing the attack or decreasing the opponent's attack, like with a marker pointing downwards, and then, you know, go from there, right? But as I mentioned before, that's not the play I'm making, at least that I made here. So suiciding with the Ibly, giving me the option to go for the Pendulum Summon, but still having Griffin on the opponent's side of the field is a problem. And Desire's also getting negated, but that's something I should have expected, right? With all of those draws, and of course Firewall Dragon's effect as well, getting multiple monsters back. Well, yeah, anyway, I believe I should have played it a little bit different. Again, going for the Link 2 to get the Ibly off of my field and then, you know, go from there. Set up my scales, go for the possible Pendulum Summon. I'm not really sure if I had, like, the Harmonizing Magician, but yeah, whatever, right? He reveals a second copy of the huge monster reborn for Goki's, and it's CG well played. Last example, again, going first with Pendulum Magicians. It's super, super easy to establish some form, some kind of lockish thingy going with Pendulum Magicians, especially with, you know, the Chronograph Sorcerer here, again, giving me the level 3 from my deck. Made sure that I still had it in the deck with at least half of the desires after desire. That is, so getting Metatron on the field, the FA, so potential 2 negates here with the FA and the Odd Eyes Vortex. Oh, and the level 6 Mythical Beast as well, I believe monster effects, if I'm not mistaken, you know, depending of, well, activating the spells, right, you know what I mean, and also one of the hand traps, right, failure in the hand, yep, more than enough. So Pendulum Magicians, okay, they lost Astrograph Sorcerer. That's definitely a huge hit for the deck. But still, the Astrograph Sorcerer, yeah, access to Astrograph Sorcerer with the Electromite just put the deck high up there. You know, it was just far beyond the other competition. Well, the play of Astrograph Sorcerer, right, with the Electromite. But now, with the loss of Astrograph Sorcerer, Pendulum Magicians took a hit. But as you saw, I mean, and this build is far from being optimized. Again, like always, feel free to leave suggestions. But again, with like more playtesting, Pendulum Magicians is still a super, super big threat going into our new TCG format. Okay, guys, like always, feel free to leave suggestions. And thanks for watching. And feel free to leave a comment or like if you enjoyed the video. Lead them out. Peace.